Welcome to an example on how to graph a parabola when the vertex is not at the origin and the parabola opens left or right. Looking at the given equation, notice how for the y terms we have a y squared term, and for the x terms we only have x to the first. This is the reason why the parabola will open left or right. So to find all of the key components of the parabola, we first want to write the equation in this form here. So looking at the left side of the equation, we want this to be a perfect square trinomial, and then we'll factor the right side. We'll have to complete the square on the left side to make this a perfect square trinomial. So we'll have y squared minus 4y plus a constant equals 8x plus 28 plus the same constant. So to complete the square here, we'll take half of the coefficient of y and square it. Well, half of negative 4 is negative 2. Negative 2 squared is equal to positive 4. So we're going to add 4 to the left side to make this a perfect square trinomial. But of course, we have to add the same constant to the right to maintain equality. So we'll have plus 4 here as well. So now we'll go ahead and factor the left and right side. This should be a perfect square trinomial. The factors of y squared are y and y. The factors of positive 4 that add to negative 4 are negative 2 and negative 2. Let's go and combine the like terms here. We have 8x plus 32. So now we can write this as the quantity y minus 2 squared equals, factor out the greatest common factor of 8. So we have 8 times the quantity x plus 4. So again, we should recognize this form. And because the y part is squared, the parabola will have a horizontal axis, meaning it will open left or right based upon the sine of a. If it fit this form here where the x part was squared, then we'd have a vertical axis and the parabola would open left or right. So for the next step, let's determine the sine of a. Again, looking at the form of the equation, we should recognize that 4a must equal 8. Well, if 4a equals 8, and we divide both sides by 4, we can see a is going to equal positive 2. So if a equals positive 2, that means the parabola will open right along the positive x-axis. Next, the vertex of the parabola will have coordinates h, k, and since we have the quantity x plus 4, the x-coordinate of the vertex is negative 4, and because we have the quantity y minus 2, the y-coordinate is positive 2. So now we're going to make a rough sketch of a parabola with a vertex of negative 4, 2, and opens to the right. And then from there we'll find the focus, directrix, axis, and so on. And then after we find the endpoints of the latus rectum, we'll make a more accurate sketch. But having a rough sketch is going to help us find all of these key components. So the vertex has coordinates negative 4, 2, which would be here. It's going to open to the right, so it's going to look something like this. The reason this helps is because now, if the parabola opens to the right, we know that the focus, or this point here, must be inside the parabola, or to the right of the vertex. The distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the absolute value of a, which is also the distance from the vertex to the directrix. And since a is equal to 2 and the absolute value of 2 is still 2, the focus would have to be 2 units to the right of the vertex, or this point here. So we can tell from the coordinate plane, the coordinates of the focus would be negative 2, 2. Another way to find the focus would have been to add a to the x-coordinate of the vertex. And then if this is the focus here, then the directrix, or this vertical line here, must pass through a point 2 units to the left of the vertex, or this point here. So this vertical line would be the directrix, and we can see the equation would be x equals negative 6. The other way to obtain this equation would be to subtract a from the x-coordinate of the vertex. Notice negative 4 minus 2 is negative 6. And then for the equation of the axis, or axis of symmetry, that would be this horizontal line here, that passes through the vertex and the focus. We can also think of this as a line that cuts the parabola in half, or the line for which the parabola is symmetrical across. So for our parabola, this would be the axis, or axis of symmetry. We can see the equation would be y equals 2. Notice that this is the same value as the y-coordinate of the vertex and the focus. So if we can understand the geometry of parabolas, we don't have to memorize all the formulas to find these key components. And then finally, to find the endpoints of the latus rectum, or focal diameter, that would be this segment here. This segment passes through the focus, is parallel to the directrix, and has both endpoints on the parabola. It also has a length equal to the absolute value of 4a. So going back to our equation, notice that 4a is equal to 8. And since the absolute value of 8 is 8, the latus rectum has a length of 8 units. And since the focus is the midpoint of the latus rectum, that means one endpoint would have to be 4 units above the focus here, and the other endpoint would have to be 4 units below the focus, which would be here. So this would be the latus rectum, or focal diameter. And again, looking at the coordinate plane, we can see one endpoint has coordinates negative 2, negative 2.
And the other endpoint is negative 2, comma 6.
Another way to obtain these coordinates would be to add and subtract 4 from the y-coordinate of the focus. Notice that 2 minus 4 is negative 2, and 2 plus 4 is equal to positive 6. Now let's go ahead and make a more accurate graph of our parabola. Using the vertex and the endpoints of the latus rectum, we know that the parabola would have to look something like this. I hope you found this helpful.